What a trip.
Absolute trip. And I mean, there's so many beautiful bits in that. I mean, what are your favorites though? And this, I think...
So, I wrote it down so that I don't forget it.
Yeah, we do.
This arrangement in the...
Okay, so actually, so here's the thing. It seems like such a polished song, but it's actually from one of their earliest albums. It's from 2003's Variations on a Dream. So, I mean, this is still before Pineapple Thief actually found their sound, which started, I guess, with Little Man and then refined later through Somewhere Here Is Missing and stuff. So, this is like, I mean, damn mature, very, very, very... I don't think like even Porcupine Tree matured this quickly. They were still mucking around.
No, absolutely not. I mean, just the way that the song is structured itself. It's just fantastic. They knew what they were doing. I mean, like Bruce.
Yeah.
Wow. Just like, I mean, the strings arrangement is just impeccable. It's so, so well done.
And
I think both of us noticed the tuned tom-toms at the
same time. I was just going to say, so if anyone thinks, anyone who's gotten to Pineapple Thief recently and thinks like it's only the post-Gavin Harrison era that had great drumming, you're very mistaken.
No.
Keith Harrison was a great drummer. And this song is a great example of that, right? Those little things, those little fresh, like the three tuned down toms are the first time I'm noticing them actually.
Yeah, me too.
Very nice. The other thing was, do you know this band called Suede by any chance? S-U-E-D?
Yeah, of course I do. What?
Yeah. Sorry. I'm like...
The British music scene is something that, you know...
So, firstly, sorry, because Suede is not a band that many people actually like react like that to. They have a song called Everything Will Flow, which this song reminds me of that. It's that opening part, right? That everything will flow. There's a song like that. And there's a song where the part where he ends with everything. And he sings it the same way. And I always sing, will flow. It ends that way. Remember, by the way, how many? This is a 16-minute song that we heard, and because I've done the, because I actually did this, I'm going to ask you, how many words do you think this song has in total? Like, how many distinct words?
Not much for a 16-minute song. That's what I would say.
Yeah.
No, there's a lot of little sections.
Take a guess because I counted.
372
unique words.
Oh,
unique words.
That's. Got to be around 120 or something, like 150.
25. I counted, by the way, while you're doing the song, during one of the down parts. Like, wow, everything's repeating. So I have this lyrics thing with my Winamp, okay? And 16-minute song, it seemed damn small. Like, where's the rest of it? Did some lyrics get chopped? Then I went, so only this, fuck, really? 1, 2, oh, okay. Then I thought I'd sit and count and see because...
25 words, that's
25 words, that's it. I think this is a song called Revolution Number... No, wait. I Want You, It's So Heavy by the Beatles.
I want you so bad.
So if you count over there, that also it's like some 20... because I Want You, She's So Heavy itself takes up about half the song. And everything else, I want you so bad, is driving me mad, is driving me mad. Last two lines are the same also. So there are very few. Mad becomes bad. Mad, so like,
that's all.
Wow. Those guys are what drugs can do to creativity. I think there is no, like, I argue, like, everyone says that Pink Floyd is the, like, band on drugs. But ironically, I don't think any of the Floyd were on drugs except for Barrett, right?
Yeah.
Like, none of them were stoners or, like, this guy, Gilmore said he's, like, done some drug, but it seemed like one of random pastimes.
Not for creative. I mean,
not for creative.
By the way, the creative force behind the band for most of the biggest albums are Roger Waters. And he doesn't. Yeah. He doesn't even smoke up. He just like...
So Bertie, so actually that's a damn interesting question. What other bands can attribute creativity to drugs like how the Beatles did? They obviously had a lot of talent, but...
Jefferson Airplane.
Huh. I forgot that scene.
If you name your band after the way... Okay, that one. Second, Fleetwood Mac.
Fleetwood Mac. Yeah.
Okay.
Although which era though? They take Fleetwood Mac is like five different years.
No, all the eras you take. No, from Peter Green to Leslie Buckingham. Yeah. There are apparently after rumors, they put them all into a studio, and the studio became a
hot box.
The entire studio was a hot box.
Really? Huh. Did not know that.
Check out Exile on Main Street by Rolling Stones. Again.
The sad thing, I guess, I don't know whether this is a sad thing to be very honest, but you won't find that shit happening now, no? You won't find, like, you won't find, like...
Yeah, see, the thing is this, right? It's just one guy making the music.
No, no, not that. That's not what I meant. That's not what I meant. Because you need to be more professional today. If you need to be in the music business, like, you're expected to deliver from word go. See, the Floyd made music at a time when, like, their eighth album was their first hit. In that sense, absolutely. they were in an era where they could afford to muck around for seven albums. Who has that luxury? Not just in terms of the industry, but even as listeners. If like a band delivers seven duds, we won't have the patience to listen to it. No,
we had this conversation before, right?
Well, yeah,
same thing. Amazing. Now you can't eat like your first track on Spotify if has it doesn't have like a 10,000 listeners. Yeah. Then nobody's going to come and pay.
And the thing is, it's not just for like mainstream music. Even people like you and me, right? Like we wouldn't, I don't know that it's kind of sad that way, but I
was talking to Naveen about this the other day.
Yeah.
Naveen, so for example,
for our listeners, please explain.
The original dog guy. Okay. So the thing is this,
say what original dog is. No, in case people don't know.
Oh, okay. Original dog is this crowdfunding.
Bertie, should I teach you everything?
You are guru management.
No, I'm going to PR you. I'm going to PR the crap out of you. Yeah.
So original dog is this.
Bertie merch will be there in a year. Mark my words. I run an Instagram account featuring cats making fun of advertising, and I sold 50 calendars of that.
Fantastic.
So you will be very easy to make merch out of. I'm telling you, if I put out on Twitter right now saying, would you buy a Bertie bobblehead? Which will randomly give you a prog suggestion every day prog suggestion.
Like or a Twitter fact. Slap the face and it'll give you a fact. Slap for a fact.
Slap this way, it'll give you a fact. Slap other way, it'll give you a prog song recommendation. I'm putting this on Kickstarter, I'm telling you.
Slap the bassist. Instead of slap the bass, slap the bassist.
Oh, dude, this is amazing. I want this. Excellent. I have ideas for Bertie merch now. Okay. What you were saying, drugs.
Original Dog is an initiative where they support indie musicians by giving them a platform for crowdfunding completely free of cost, where you can put up your music, your video, everything, and then reach out to people. That's it. Completely free of cost.
That's very cool. That's very cool.
They already have like about 40, 50 artists, and they've already made money. They've made videos using the money that they've crowdfunded.
That's very cool, man. That's very cool. That's very nice.
So, Naveen, I was talking about the
biggest... And for context, Bertie just finished his first one, which was on Pink Floyd yesterday at the time of recording. So, while you are seeing this, those Bertie bobbleheads might actually be in front of you and, you know, might be a completely different thing. Anyway, move on.
So, I was talking to him about Dua Lipa. Now, Dua Lipa is the biggest artist out of 2020. Right? And people know her songs, but I don't know if anybody else has heard the album in its entirety.
Yeah.
Right. And she knows the business. So she, like, you know, made sure that every song she did, she had a particular hype to it. But the other day I sat and listened to it as an album.
Yeah.
And it's a completely different trip on its own. Right. But nobody ever does.
Nobody does that.
On Spotify itself, only if you click on see discography and you go down, the album is there.
Yeah.
Or else it's all a top hits on top. And that's how it works.
Yeah. I don't necessarily think that there's a bad thing. I see people lamenting the death of the album. Like, so what? It's okay. Like, it's different now. The album was a disruptor at one point of time. You have to remember, like, everything. In a few years, I think it will be... Already for many people, when they think of music, the first thing they think of is a music video rather than a song, just pure audio. And I think, that could
be... change that. So I was talking about this yesterday, the fact that Dark Side of the Moon, right? I heard it on tape.
Yeah.
And my Walkman did not have that forward reverse. It had, but it didn't work. Right? And you have to keep doing it till you enter it. You can't skip.
Yesterday you were hearing. That's how hipster you were.
No. This is when I was a kid.
Oh,
when
kid. I thought like yesterday. I don't know. Like, you do these things.
So Dark Side
if somebody told me one of your friends has been listening to Dark Side of the Moon on a Walkman yesterday, I would be like, huh. A few people are there. Bertie is very easy, one of them.
I do have a Sony Walkman. Fair. I don't have Dark Side of the Moon.
Fair enough. You obviously have the sheet music for animals also somewhere.
the Sony Walkman actually has greatest hits of Jagjit Singh. If you want to, that's
what okay, I mean. Okay, we're ramming. At least I'm ramming. So
no, the thing is this. So in Dark Side of the Moon, I had to listen to all the songs. There was no skip. There was no forward. There's no reverse. Yeah, yeah. Right. If given a chance, maybe if I skipped Great Gig This Time because I thought it was weird, I would have never gone to love the song. Because on the first listen, it's like...
Yeah.
Right. Now, this song which you just heard, Remember Us, is just... It's one of those songs where you have to be in the right place.
That's
and
true.
You have to listen to it in really good sound. And I love the fact that Pineapple Thief happened now.
Mm.
In this particular era.
Yeah.
I don't think they would have... I don't know if in any other era they would have taken off as much as they are going to do now. But the fact that technological advancements and the fact that people can listen to such things in this format is going to help them do very well. And we are personally going to be responsible for them becoming a big thing in India.
We are?
That's what you're going to tell me.
What are we... because of this, because of these videos. Yeah. Oh, okay. I mean, not getting them down. Or are we?
Okay. Why not?
It's not a cover band. Pineapple. It's steal their songs. Pineapple Thief.
Pineapple Thief.
Very sad. Okay.